this poem was written by an old Arizona cowboy by the name of Gail Gardner. I got to know Gail before he died just here a few years ago, and this song was wrote as a poem but put to music, and it became a very famous cowboy song, too. It's called Tying Knots in the Devil's Tail. Away up high in the Sierra Peaks, where the yellowjack pines grow tall, old Sandy Bob and Buster Jiggs had a roe deer camp last fall. Now they'd taken their horses and branding irons, maybe a dog or two, and they allowed they'd brand all the long-eared calves that'd come within their view. And any old dogie that flapped long ears didn't bush up a day'd get his long ears whittled and his old hide scorched in a most artistic way. Now, one fine day, old Sandy Bobby throwed his seago down, says, I'm sick of the smell of this burning hair, and I allows I'm going to town. So they saddles up and hits him a lope, for it weren't no sight of a ride, and them was the days when a buckaroo could aisle up his insides. They starts her off at the Kentucky bar to hit a whiskey row. They ends her up the depot house some 40 drinks below. Then they sets up, turns around, goes her the other way, and to tell you the godforsaken truth, them boys got stewed that day. Well, as they's riding back to camp, packing a pretty good load, who should they meet but the devil himself a-prancing down the road. Says he, you ornery old cowboy skunks, you'd better hunt your hole, for I've just rode up from the hell's rim rock to gather in your souls. Old Sandy Bob said, devil, be damned, we boys is kind of tight, but you ain't a-gonna gather no cowboy soul without one hell of a fight. So Sandy Bob punched a hole in his rope. He swung her straight and true. He lapped it on the devil's horns, and he'd taken his dallies, too. Now Buster Jiggs was a Rieta man. His gut lines coiled up neat. He takes her down, shakes her out, and lasts that devil's hind feet. Well, they stretch him out, tail him down while the iron's getting hot. Crop and Swaller forked his ears, and they branded him up a lot. They pruned him up with dehorning shears, tied knots in his tail for joke, then they just rode off and left him there, neck to a blackjack oak. So if you're ever up on the Sierra Peaks and you hear one hell of a wail, it's just that devil bellering about the knots they tied in his tail.
That's the way it ought to be.